But it's like, look what he's doing, able to do for his family.
Oh, again, I'm like, I don't like to be so emotional. Cool. But ladies and gentlemen, I am so excited for today's podcast. Woo! Oh my gosh, this is a video reaction and I'm excited because we have Victoria here.
I can't wait. It's going to be good.
And this is dropping today and we get to come into the studio. And so I'm glad it worked out.
Yes.
We are going to be reacting to Tom McDonald's God Mode. What? And it's a long video.
Yeah.
It's a long one.
8 minutes, 24 seconds.
Yes. And before we get into it, I just want to thank our viewers and our subscribers out there. I appreciate you guys and the love that you guys sent. The super thanks. If you guys want to support this channel, go ahead and click on the super thanks. There's a little link below.
Keep the energy drinks coming.
And there was
yes. And other things, but you know.
And there was a guy I want to give a shout out to. He said we didn't have to do it, but I just want to honor those who have been helping this channel. EF445. And you're that'll awesome. Be on the screen. Yeah, thank you.
Appreciate you big time. This is just like so fun for us to do. Yeah. And then like to actually have people who kind of like enjoy watching us just like goof off is like a really cool surreal thing. So,
and we appreciate you guys. We thank you for the comments on our last video and we want to keep on giving people shout outs, continue to conversate with you guys and hear what you guys have to say. It's totally encouraging. So, thank you once again. So let's go ahead and get into this video reaction with Tom McDonald. God mode. I don't even know what that means. God mode.
I honestly don't either. I'm trying to like kind of come up with something to kind of paint the picture for me already, but
it sounds better than beast mode. You know what I mean? Like, if you hear people saying, I'm going to go in beast mode.
Yeah. Yeah, I guess we'll kind of see.
So let's get into it. My name is Jacob.
And I'm Victoria.
And this is Ignite Fire. All right, let's get into this video reaction. Oh my goodness. Let's see.
He already looks so intense. I know. Wow, this is going to be heavy.
Ooh. All right, guys, let's go ahead and get into it. This is much anticipated.
I've been hearing that they think my political music is boring. Tell them I'm sorry.
Boring?
Before we gotta give a warning disclaimer to everyone that's out there.
Yeah.
This is probably gonna be a long video, guys. This is gonna be a long video because we love Tom McDonald. We love the fans. We love those who watch. And
we also love rabbit trails.
And we love rabbit trails, yes. And so this looks like a long rabbit trail. So I'm gonna start this over again. I just wanted to give a disclaimer to those who are out there.
I've been hearing that they think my political music is boring. Tell them I'm sorry. I've been rapping about things that I feel are important. I can talk about how rich I am, all these little rappers that I'm bigger than. I could show you the impact addiction had, how the liquor turned me to a different man. Ooh. I'm not the kid who was visiting Disneyland. I'm not a perfect Christian, have a sinner's pass, but I sobered up, prescriptions hit the trash. Now I'm sitting back with 50 billboard plaques, $20 million and a million fans. Middle fingers flipping, I can't flip them back. I'm so independent, so they get the message. I've been spitting facts, I'm not a fiction fan. I am the truth, I am the GOAT, I am the proof. You can reach every one of your goals. You can be too drunk, way too high, but it's never too late to have hope. I am the one. I'm gonna preach. You can reach every one of your dreams. You can be up against the whole entire world and you can beat them if you just believe. Saying I'm Illuminati and I'm going to hell. They're desperately searching for any excuse to explain why I've done what they can't do themselves. The only way they can make sense of my famous claim, I worship Satan and labels of health. I don't have an advantage. It's natural talent. Your ego is damaged. Admit that you failed. I remember back when I was the only political rapper.
Wow.
Hold on. What the?
The dynamic just totally changed.
Yeah. It was like, I knew it was coming.
Yeah.
But I, you know, it was like setting you up.
Yeah.
It was setting you up.
Wow. Yeah. That's heavy stuff. What he was talking about, just like with, you know, the fact, you know, political rap is boring when in reality he's like, look, I could be talking about all these other crappy things that these other rappers are talking about.
Yeah.
But look what I'm actually doing.
Yeah.
Kind of thing. So that's interesting.
I really like Tom's message. Mm-hmm. And he's like, I'm a preach.
Yeah.
I'm a preach it. Preach it.
The only way they can make sense of my famous claim, I worship Satan and labels of health. I don't have an advantage. It's natural talent.
Oh, wait, sorry. Admit that actually, I didn't catch that line before. The only way that they make sense of what I do is like I worship Satan or something.
Oh.
That's so interesting. That's a really crazy line because I think a lot of people will try to like make sense of somebody or put somebody in a box by saying like, oh, they worship Satan or oh, they like blah, blah, blah. Oh, they're part of the Illuminati, just whatever.
They sold their soul.
Yeah, exactly. When in reality, they're just like doing what they know how to do to exploit truth.
Yeah, yeah.
So Not exploit truth. Expose. Hello.
Expose. Expose.
Wow.
Expose.
They've been saying I'm Illuminati and I'm going to hell. They're desperately searching for any excuse to explain why I've done what they can't do themselves. The only way they can make sense of my famous claim, I worship Satan and labels of health. I don't have an advantage. It's natural talent. Your ego is damaged. Admit that you failed. I remember back when
I was the only political. That's a line.
What the hell happened? All of a sudden, everyone who never gave a damn got political and started rapping. Tragic. I should be flattered. Man, I created the genre. They practically jacked it. Acting like they're in the conversation. They ain't nowhere near it on a different planet. This is not YouTube. This is upper echelon. I'm president of Sony on my telephone. I get what I want, how I want, when I want, until the day that I'm dead and gone. The internet in love with beef, they want rappers at war. But I don't care who's coming at me, I swore that I wouldn't do disses no more. The last time I battled the man that I trampled, lost his career and then had a divorce. That wasn't fair, homie got torched. I feel the weight like I'm carrying around a corpse. Still no deal, still no team, still just little old me. Still making fun of the whole industry, still rap on my own beats. I'm the only multimillionaire in my family tree. Oof. I keep hearing rumors that my parents rich and that's how I got in the lead. That's a big L-I-E. If you want to know the truth, I guess I can show you why I move like this. Let me take you back into my head. Tell you about the movie I live.
Whoa.
Dang, he's spitting fire right now. This is crazy. Whoa.
Yeah. 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 Oh, my gosh. Oh, my gosh.
Okay. We're kind of speechless right now. This is intense.
I feel like he's about to take us on a journey.
Yeah. Memory lane.
He's about to take us on a journey, ladies and gentlemen. Are you guys ready to go into this? Oh, my gosh. Okay, we're going back.
Here we go.
Oh, my gosh. Yeah, this one's intense.
Take us to story, Brooke.
Rap on my own beats. I'm the only multimillionaire in my family tree. I keep hearing rumors that my parents rich and that's how I got in the lead. That's a big L-I-E. If you want to know the truth, I guess I can show you why I move like this. Let me take you back into my head. Tell you about the movie I live. For an alcoholic, nothing in my wallet. Every doctor said that I was depressed. Should be in a coffin or inside a cardboard box and addicted to meth. I was sleeping on my best friend's couch. Always dreaming of a West End house. We was living in the basement, sweet east side brand. We get out. Motorcycles on the front lawn, bunch of crackheads in the alley. Open up my bedroom window and tell them there's empty bottles they can have. Cops at the door, I couldn't sleep. Making up noodles to eat for a week. I couldn't stomach the food I was making if I wasn't high, so I always had weed. Leaving the crib and the neighbors are tripping. I flip them the bird, I ain't stopping to talk. They leaving us notes on the passenger window because we always park in the whip in they spot. 10 in the morning, we sipping on 40s and taking the Honda Civic up the block. Looking for one of my homies who living on the street because he got addicted to rocks. Waiting in line at church, they giving out food. I would pull up every second Sunday, get some hard-boiled eggs and juice. That was the move. I was a broke boy, then I blew up. I was suicidal, yeah, the mood sucked. Now I've been rich, I done made hits. I've been praying, I don't screw it up. Wow. Now that I've blown up, they're mad that I've grown up. They missing my old stuff. They say my political music's all sounding the same and the flow suck. I'm never gonna be the old Tom or recapture the magic of old songs. I don't know, Tom. You the goat, Tom. Give me what I want or I will go, Tom.
Those look so cool on his hands. I'm not the guy that
you... Dang.
Dude.
Man.
This is like a lot to catch. I'm like trying to process as it all like happening right now.
Yeah, we're going to have to listen. I want to listen to this a couple of times.
Yeah, like, for sure.
So guys, we apologize if we're missing stuff, but he's talking about a lot of the struggles of his life. And it's intense that he's being so. That's one thing I really love about Tom MacDonald is that he is open and real, and he's not afraid to share a lot of his struggles or where he's coming from, you know? And I think that that's really important. And I think that's why I relate to him. I don't know about you guys, but I know that's one reason that I relate to him is because he's so real and open. So I'm going to go back a couple of seconds and we're going to get back into this. Man, this is, I'm feeling emotional, you know, just listening to it.
It's heavy.
Oh yeah.
Stuff. They say my political music's all sounding the same and the flow suck. I'm never gonna be the old Tom or recapture the magic of old songs. I don't know, Tom. You the goat, Tom. Give me what I want or I will go, Tom.
Shut up!
I'm not the guy that you fell in love with back when I was young and dumb. Always getting drunk, taking hella drugs, living in the ghetto, no food for a month. Couldn't pay the power bill, the shower filled with towels, mold, and hella bugs. That was the old Tom. That was broke Tom. Stop saying you miss who I was. Now you can give me
Oh my gosh. Okay. You know, I relate to that because I used to be this real big party guy and I was always drinking. I was always partying. I was always broke because I spent all my money on parties and house parties and whatnot. I was always depressed. I was always struggling. I always needed the attention of a female. I always needed like a girlfriend or something. I found my worth in all of that. And then I remember when I started to change and people were like, man, I miss the old you. And I'm like, oh, you don't even know like the struggle of what I was in, you know? And then to hear people say that, but they just, you know, they just don't know.
Yeah, I know. Because it's definitely like all of that stuff, just like he's saying, it comes from such a broken place of, you know, just the innate hurt and just like lack of, you know, there's like a God-sized void in all of us, right? Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. And if we're filling it with all of these different things, like, and then when we start to empty those things out and we really do fill it with the Lord now, mm-hmm. it's like, you know, when we go through a transformation, when we start seeing changes like totally flop in our life, mm-hmm. that like we're never going to keep the same friends. You know what I mean? Yeah, like it's just, it's all, if we shift, they're going to shift.
Or they're going to move out.
Yeah, exactly. And it's like, that's the way it should be though. Because mm-hmm. if those people still feel comfortable to, you know, do as they're doing around you, still even seeing the change, then it's like, there's something not quite right going on.
Yeah.
Right. So yeah, it's just interesting if you're still keeping like all of the same people around you. It's like last night when I went to that young adults thing, they were saying like, show me that your five best friends and I'll show you your future.
Ooh.
And it's like, if you're still keeping those same people around you that were around you in that season of your life, mm-hmm. then you're going to get roped back in.
Yeah. Yeah.
You're not going to see like actual change.
Mm-hmm,
so.
Mm-hmm. No, I think there's definitely a lot of truth to that. And then as you grow, sometimes your friends will either grow with you or you outgrow them, you know?
And there's nothing wrong with either of those. Mm-mm. There's nothing wrong with either of those. It's just life. It's just like seasons change. There's a time for certain people in your life. There's a time for other people in your life. Mm-hmm. Some people stay for a lifetime. Other people don't.
Yeah.
And it's like, that's such a natural thing that I think a lot of people will have to grieve, but it's just something we all have to walk through. So.
Here's a public announcement. Ladies and gentlemen, I just want to say right now from the voice of God to you, if you're watching this, is where God wants to take you. Sometimes your friends can't come.
Mm-hmm.
And you got to go where the Lord is pulling you because he has so much stuff better for you.
Yeah.
So thank you, Tom, for sharing this. Woo. Oh my goodness. And let's get back into the video.
All right. We are 3 minutes in.
Oh my gosh. Yeah.
Back when I was young and dumb, always getting drunk, taking hella drugs, living in the ghetto, no food for a month, couldn't pay the power bill, the shower filled with towels, mold, and hella bugs. That was the old Tom, that was broke Tom. Stop saying you miss who I was. Now you can give me all the Gucci, give me all the Louis, give me everything I want at once. Give me Lamborghinis, give me all my flowers, give you everything I have just to be loved. Now they call me racist and they say I'm canceled, but I guarantee you that there will be blood. I ain't going nowhere, I ain't stopping nothing, I'ma really go there, I don't give a f- I'm the best thing going right now, they can't mess with me. I've been up, I've been down, I climbed out my grave. I'll be great, way before today, and I'll be great till I decide to walk away. And I'm the one you have to thank for every independent artist getting billboard.
Hold on. He said, I'll be great till I walk away. Oh my God. Goodness, he's just...
This is like, I know, for real, that's what it feels like. It's like, whoa, it's just like such a power ballad, though.
Yeah.
You know, well, not ballad, but you know what I mean.
Yeah, like, yeah.
He's
stepping into who he was created to be.
It's, wow.
This Ladies is so and gentlemen, good. Do you know who God created you to be? Because then you'll enter the God mode. Let's go back. Oh my gosh, man.
I'll be great till I decide to walk away. And I'm the one you have to thank for every independent artist getting billboard plaques. I showed everybody how to beat the record labels and still I don't get no thanks. Everybody who's been hating on me copies every little thing I'm doing. I mean, they dress like me, sign CDs, no one is buying their music. I'm the blueprint for these YouTube kids. Every single little view you get, every time you get an iTunes check, you just imitate what I do best. I'm on Fox News, I'm on Rolling Stone, in the New York Times, on the radio, got a billion views, million on the gram, you still paying to be verified, man. I am the reason that Billboard removed all the digital sales charts off their website. I was outperforming label artists and executives pressured them to hit the red light. Universal, Warner Music, Sony, CEOs wanted me dead, but they ain't never gonna really kill me. They just canceled the digital charts instead.
What? Dang. Did you know that?
Uh-uh.
Oh my gosh, what wow. the... What the?
What the?
Oh my gosh.
This is sorry, I just kind of have to pause here because I kept like trying to think about like why he called this God mode. Like what about this like means God mode? But I wonder, this kind of reminds me of how like God would respond to Israel when they would like stray away from him.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And it's kind of like just like how he's saying, like you have me to thank for all of these other independent artists and just like all this stuff. Like they dress like me. They, you know, just like whatever.
Yeah.
And but he's still not getting the recognition or thanks from them.
Ooh, yeah.
You know what I mean? Yeah. So that's kind of what hit me right there. It's like, oh, this kind of reminds me of that.
Yeah.
Not like saying that he's a god or anything, but it's just very much like, you know, he kind of paved the way for these people.
Yeah.
Right. That's what he's saying. And they're not, you know,
even acknowledging it.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Yeah. And they're trashing on him.
Yeah. Because
that's exactly what Israel did to God.
And people right? are still doing it now.
Yeah, exactly. And they worshiped other gods. They are worshiping other gods when in reality they should be thanking and having gratitude towards the Lord.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Interesting.
But it's interesting. Anything that's good, the world comes against.
Absolutely. Anything, they pervert it.
Anything that's preaching, that's the truth, anything that is contradictory to the narrative of Satan in the world, it's like, oh, let's attack it.
Yeah.
But we are with you, Tom. Oh, yeah.
Views Millie on the gram. You still paying to be verified, man.
I am the reason that Billboard removed all the digital sales charts off their website.
What?
I was outperforming label artists and executives pressured them to hit the red light. Universal, Warner Music, Sony, CEOs wanted me dead, but they ain't never gonna really kill me. They just canceled the digital charts instead. Stop telling me that anyone else is bigger than I am. Go get the Nielsen sound scan numbers. Tell me what you find, man. Who's the biggest I am? They're angry that I love America. Guess it's a problem because I'm Canadian.
This reminds me of Godzilla.
Yeah, that's actually kind of cool.
He's Godzilla.
He's the biggest thing right now. That's you know funny. What's crazy is I believe he really is one of the biggest voices in the industry, but the actual industry won't even acknowledge him. But it doesn't even matter, you know, because he's bigger. He's bigger than they are.
Yeah,
you know.
Yeah,
which is pretty cool.
Mm-hmm. Well, it's because he's saying things that people are uncomfortable with.
Yeah,
you know. So why would they?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. But there's an awakening happening, ladies and gentlemen. There is an awakening happening.
Tell me what you find, man. Who's the biggest I am? They're angry that I love America. Guess it's a problem because I'm Canadian.
Dang.
I live in the States. I gave $200,000 to the veterans. I am a patriot. I am not faking this. I don't need to keep on making hits. Could have retired 3 years ago, basically. Go check my bank account, buddy. I'm crazy rich. I don't need money. I rap because I'm made for this. I am only doing this because I love it. I told every record label they can shove it. Rappers hate on me, but I'm above it. 93 Shawn Michaels. Everyone can suck it. They want photos when they see me out in public, then they trash me in the comments. What a bummer. Ooh. I sign autographs and spill my guts.
Okay, there were a couple things that I really liked there, just how he was saying that, you know, if you check my bank account, like I'm rich, like whatever, I do this because I'm made for it though.
Yeah.
And I'm like, oh, if more people would do what they do
because
they were made for it. Like, how amazing would the music industry be? How amazing would real estate be? All of these different markets, all these different industries. It's like, how incredible would it actually be if people weren't in for it for the money?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, money is just a reaped reward
for
great work.
They would get it.
Yeah, exactly. But I love that. And then he was saying how people act one way in front of him and then another way in the comments.
Oh,
because they hide behind their keyboards. They hide behind their laptops saying like, oh, Tom, you're trash. When they see him, they're like, oh, let's get a picture.
Yeah.
Like, what the frick? Make up your mind.
They just want to be like him.
Yeah. It's that jealousy, the envy, like all that stuff. But interesting. Oh, yeah. We're a little over halfway through. We're making it.
Oh, yeah. We're actually doing really good. Man. Well, he's saying so much.
93 Shawn Michaels. Everyone can suck it. They want photos when they see me out in public. Then they trash me in the comments. What a bummer. I sign autographs and spill my guts and stomach. All I get is people praying that I'll plummet.
Ugh.
I came a long way. Dreamt of this all day. I should have saw graves, but God saves. I got faith. What a loser. Woo!
Oh, wait. He said,
I should have saw graves, but God faith.
God saves.
Faith and God saves. Yeah.
Yeah. Is that what he said? Hold on. We're going to go back. Just
yeah.
Real
saw
quick.
Graves. Got faith.
Hold on.
God saves.
Dreamt of this all day. I should have saw graves, but God saves. I got faith. What a loser. I
oh, my God.
Dude.
What?
What?
I knew. I knew Tom was a brother. Not, and I don't mean black. I mean, he was a brother in Christ. I knew it. I knew it.
I think we guessed that, like, when we first did the system.
Yeah.
I think we might have guessed that, but.
Yeah. No, this is good. So this is good. Oh, my gosh. I just immediately like this even more. So, holy moly.
The comments, what a bummer. I sign autographs and spill my guts and stomach. All I get is people praying that I'll plummet. I came a long way. Dreamt of this all day. I should have saw graves, but God saves. I got faith, what a loser. I needed boost to maneuver. Bottles of hooch in the cooler. Now I'm the proof that you can choose to be a trooper and recruit and pursue a future, be a ruler. Screw all the rumors and all the dudes who be acting stupid on computers. Hate is a fuel that humans can use to improve themselves if they don't let their wounds ruin their movement. You can do it and then you can lose it. You can choose to view it through some different pupils. You can shoot for the moon if you miss it. Recoup it and then execute it till you make it through it. There ain't no excuses. The rules are confusing, so break them and use them to find the solution. The truth is you're losing till you are immune and you turn the abuse into your revolution.
I've been addicted to plenty of pills.
Wow.
Oh my
He
God.
Said a lot right there.
We gotta go back.
That was really that was really good. Just he was saying basically, like, you know, how he used hate to fuel him to get better.
Yeah, yeah.
And I'm like, wow, if only people would use that rather than, you know, staying offended.
Yeah, and let it hurt them and and wound them.
Become a little sissy. Like, dude. Sorry, Ebony.
We don't need any sissy lalas in here. Okay, guys. No sissy lalas up in here.
Take your offense somewhere else. Deal with that with the Lord. Have fun.
Yeah. Okay, we're going to listen to that one more time. Because
there was a lot in there.
Oh my gosh. Oh.
I should have saw graves, but God saves. I got faith. What a loser. I needed boost to maneuver. Bottles of hooch in the cooler. Now I'm the proof that you can choose to be a trooper and recruit and pursue a future, be a ruler. Screw all the rumors and all the dudes who be acting stupid on computers. Hate is a fuel that humans can use to improve themselves if they don't let their wounds ruin their movement. You can do it and then you can lose it. You can choose to view it through some different pupils. You can shoot for the moon if you miss it. Recoup it and then execute it till you make it through it. There ain't no excuses. The rules are confusing, so break them and use them to find the solution. The truth is you're losing till you are immune and you turn the abuse into your revolution.
I've been addicted to plenty of pills, poor and mentally ill. If I can do it, you can do it. I went from homeless and drunk to turning down record deals. I got so many wins that I forget the wins. So many plaques inside the crib, they're getting hard to live. They so jealous, I'm just glad that I ain't them. Thank God I ain't them. They got money, they got pennies, they got dollars, but they ain't been making any sense. They got hundreds, they got thousands. I got 10, 11, 15, 20 something names. But this ain't always what my life was like. Honestly, it still give me chills. Way before all of my viral songs, before I was living in Beverly Hills, way before I went and sobered up, back when me and Brandon couldn't pay the bills, way back when I should have been locked up, overdosed or getting killed. My sister called me from the hospital, said her job's killing her, and that was a fact.
Oh, dang, that's his sister.
Often,
out of options,
Hold on, I'm gonna go back. That's cool. I was missing what he said.
My sister called me from the hospital, said her job's killing her, and that was a fact. She working overtime often, out of options, having panic attacks. Didn't let her finish talking, told her walk in and to quit and call back. Next thing I know, she's in California and she's working for Hangover Gang. And daddy always told me I was special and one day I would conquer the music business. And I guess he was right, because look at my life. I just bought him a new Porsche for Christmas and mama worked harder than any woman on earth. Her boss would have never have fired her. I recognized they weren't giving her what she was worth, so I retired her.
This ain't what?
Oh man,
that's so cool.
Yeah, no, that's
he just got his whole family jobs.
Yeah,
that's I'm like, so getting, I'm like,
I'm trying, I'm not, I don't that's like to be so emotional, cool. But I'm getting emotional right now. And you know, there's always a I believe that God assigns in every family a chain breaker.
Yeah,
you know, God assigns someone that is going to radically change the family and elevate everybody. And not everyone will come to the call, you know, not everyone will rise to the level that God has created them to be to set their family free. But I believe there's a Moses in every family.
Oof.
And yes, Tom, I'm saying you are the Moses of your family.
That's so cool.
And to a lot of people, I think his message has helped a lot of people.
Oh my gosh, yeah.
You know? Okay, I want to listen to that one more time.
Oh, that's so good.
Oh, man.
Because nobody ever sees this side of him.
No.
And they just judge him for his, you know, political context.
Yeah.
But it's like, look what he's doing, able to do for his family.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? Like, there's such a pure heart behind all of that.
And we should all and we should all be able to do that for our families, you know? And bless them and help them and and deliver, you know?
Yeah.
And I believe that's one thing that I really love about our Christian faith is just like Moses and all of the leaders and a lot of the good leaders that God has called in the Old Testament, New Testament, they were deliverers of their people.
Yeah.
They came to set them free. They weren't the best people. They've made mistakes.
Yeah.
Our history is full of mistakes and issues and problems, but that doesn't change the message that God has used imperfect people to deliver those who are oppressed, you know?
So good.
Okay, let's go back and listen to this.
Killed. My sister called me from the hospital, said her job's killing her, and that was a fact. She working overtime often, out of options, having panic attacks. Didn't let her finish talking, told her walk in and to quit and call back. Next thing I know, she's in California and she's working for Hangover Gang. And daddy always told me I was special and one day I would conquer the music business. And I guess he was right, because look at my life. I just bought him a new Porsche for Christmas, and mama worked harder than any woman on earth. Her boss would have never have fired her. I recognized they weren't giving her what she was worth, so I retired her.
This ain't white privilege, so cool. This ain't trust fund, this ain't good luck, this ain't silver spoon, this is hard work, this is long nights, this is all me, this is what I do, this is palm trees and Ferraris and a calm breeze and a pretty view. If you don't believe I deserve it, then you never lived the life I did and you wouldn't make
Dang.
It through.
Came out of
city where I still don't get no respect.
Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh.
Yes.
We got to go back on that.
That's so cool. If you don't think I deserve it, you never lived the life that I did.
Yeah. Oh my gosh. People are so quick to judge. But,
I know. Oh my gosh.
Okay.
This is so good, guys.
Oh my gosh.
What?
Okay. I want to listen to that one more time. Sorry, guys.
Her what she was worth, so I retired her.
This ain't white privilege, this ain't trust fund, this ain't good luck, this ain't silver spoon, this is hard work, this is long nights, this is all me, this is what I do, this is palm trees and Ferraris and a calm breeze and a pretty view. If you don't believe I deserve it, then you never lived the life I did and you wouldn't make it through. I came out of city where I still don't get no respect. I moved away and I blew up and everyone else is still stuck in the town that I left. I'm not impressed and they've been saying my video views are all fake and I honestly hope it helps get them some rest. I'm worth like 30 million $30 million, all you bums are living check to check. Now everybody is an enemy, they all jealous that I'm a celebrity. Well, screw them, screw the government, screw the record label, screw the mainstream. I'm in God mode, they in beast mode.
We are Dang, I knew it,
there
I
it
knew
is. It. I'm in God mode, they're in beast mode.
Yeah.
That's funny.
My God. There's a line drawn in the sand, ladies and gentlemen. There's a line drawn in the sand, and you either on God's side or you on the devil's side. Either God is your father or the devil's your daddy. I've been saying that. And you know what? I really liked the interview with Cat Williams. Mm-hmm. And he said that. He's like, there's a line. And he's like, you're either on God's side or on the other. He's like, there's no, and I believe that there's only two sides.
And there's no in between either.
No.
There's no in between. I'm just going to say this really quick.
Yeah.
But I heard this metaphor where somebody was talking to this guy and he was saying that, just like there's that line, but the line was kind of like this fence, right?
Uh-huh.
And so on one side was the Lord's side and then on the other was the enemy's, right? And then this guy, he was just kind of stuck in unbelief. He was like, I don't know which side I want to be on. And so he tried not to decide.
Oh.
And he was just sitting on the fence.
Uh-huh.
And so then the devil comes up to him and he's like, hey, you belong to us. And the guy was like, no, I didn't pick a side. And he was like, the fence is ours.
Oh.
The fence is his. Guys, you can't just not pick. You can't just not pick.
Oh,
you don't get excluded from
gosh.
That. Like, you got to pick.
Yeah.
And
if you haven't, it's already decided for
exactly.
you.
Exactly. If you, quote unquote, God. Haven't picked, you already did.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Ugh, it's just, I wish people understood that fact. Can't just sit on the sidelines because there's no sideline.
Yeah. Yeah. If you're casual about life, you'll be a casualty.
Yeah.
Ooh, man.
That's a word.
Now everybody is an enemy, they all jealous that I'm a celebrity. Well, screw them, screw the government, screw the record label, screw the mainstream. I'm in God mode, they in beast mode. We are not the same, we ain't equals. And I pray to God that you can deep throat. Got 11 inches for you weak hoes. You cannot critique me, y'all ain't in my league still. All your hate completes me, I can't be killed. Y'all just wanna be me, maybe be chill. Leave them bleeding in a wheat field. All my missiles heat seek, you can beat me. Homie, keep still, I can tell that you don't eat meat. Ton of green beans, you a vegan when the beef's real. Everybody's saying I'm fake, but they're the ones who really faking though, and their songs all on YouTube. Well, my songs on the radio. They claim they hate fame, but they change when they need streams. Then they say names and play games and take game and hate on me.
Wait, I got one more
thing. We're going to need to listen to that again.
Holy. Okay, yeah, we're going to go back.
That whole vegan and meat thing went over my head. I was like, what's happening? Yeah. So forgive me for that.
But... We're going to go back. Okay. Holy crap.
Okay, I'm really paying attention.
Cannot critique me, y'all ain't in my league still. All your hate completes me, I can't be killed. Y'all just wanna be me, maybe be chill. Leave them bleeding in a wheat field. All my missiles heat seek, you can beat me. Homie, keep still, I can tell that you don't eat meat. Ton of green beans, you a vegan when the beef's real. Everybody say...
Hey, there's something wrong with
what
vegans.
What am I missing?
There's something wrong with vegans. No, I think he's just dropping bars right now. He's dropping bars, but...
Is it a metaphor, though? I'm really confused. Guys, if you know what he's trying to say... Please put it in the comments. I'm lost on that part.
Well, I think something's wrong with vegans in the first place. So,
They're not healthy.
No. You can't trust vegans. You can't trust vegans. If you don't eat meat, are you an American?
I could never
USDA,
be vegan.
Stamped and approved.
I like my chicken nuggies a little too much. Just saying.
Yeah. No, he's dropping some bars, though. He's dropping bars. Holy moly.
Yeah, if you guys know what he means, let me know, please.
Is there more to that statement?
Hey, homie, keep still. I can tell that you don't eat meat. Ton of green beans. You a vegan when the beef's real. Everybody's saying I'm fake, but they're the ones who...
Is it kind of like just a very substance of truth that he's kind of talking about?
Like the meat's real, but you're eating vegan.
Yeah, you're just deciding not to... I could be way overthinking, but I just... thought I'd chime in. Fun. Anyway.
Texas, just a shout out to Texas Roadhouse. I mean, I'm thinking about steak right now. I kind of want to go get a prime rib and get some food. Oh, man, I'm getting hungry now. I'm talking about all this steak.
You a vegan when the beef's real. Everybody's saying I'm fake, but they're the ones who really faking, though. And their songs all on YouTube. Well, my songs on the radio. They claim they hate fame, but they change when they need streams. Then they say names and play games and take game and hate on me.
Wait, I got one more thing to say.
I don't need any more money. These days I just do it for all of my fans. I pray to God I inspire somebody or show someone who thinks they can't that they can. I'ma keep going till I'm in the coffin. I promise no stopping till I kick the can.
To the day that they're dropping my box in the ground, it's hang over gang.
Oh my God. That is a cool picture of his family and stuff. Dude. Oh man. Hangover gang for life. What? I'm rolling with y'all.
This is awesome. Oh my gosh. That was so much. Yeah. I'm like processing all of that.
Ooh, man. Let's just take a moment to just breathe that in.
Right.
Because this was amazing. I'm grateful, Victoria, that you're able to come in today.
Yeah, me too.
I knew that since we did our last video, people were putting in the comments that he was dropping a new album today. And I didn't even realize that it was actually coming out this morning at 9 o'clock.
Yeah.
So this is pretty awesome.
Yay!
So guys, I want to listen to this again and give it the respect that it's due. Yeah. Because Tom MacDonald is an amazing artist. He has an amazing message. The way that he comes out is very unique. And the fact that he was talking about his faith, and I think that that's pretty awesome. And I am rolling with Hangover Gang.
There you go. I honestly wonder, maybe we can do like a part two of this where we review it again in a couple months.
Yeah.
And like after listening to it a few times. And just kind of getting like a full picture of it rather than just like a first time reaction, you know?
Yeah.
Because I feel like I just missed a lot, I feel. So I would love to review it again.
So guys, if you'd like us to do a piece by piece breakdown and actually go through this, let us know in the comments below.
Yeah.
Because this was a very good song.
I really enjoyed this. There were so many just thematic, you know.
Yeah. There's a lot of layers to it.
So much depth. Yeah.
And yeah, I'd like to break it down. But my reaction to this is it's freaking awesome.
Mm-hmm.
I am grateful that I was able to be a witness to this.
Yeah.
And to all those that are out there. Obviously, Hangover Gang is legit. And all the Tom MacDonald fans are awesome. Thank you guys for supporting this channel and the super thanks and helping us and just encouraging us to keep doing these video reviews. So we thank you for all of that. And if there's people out there that are struggling, just the message to you guys is from Tom MacDonald and our message too is you can do it. You can change. You can get out of the situations that you're in. And I especially for myself, I rely on God and my faith in Him, in Jesus, and I am I know that He saved me. I know that I have a relationship with Him, and because of that, He has brought me through so many things. Yeah. And it's just really cool to hear Tom kind of, you know, just share a little bit of that.
Yeah,
and absolutely. Have that in the background.
It's very cool. Very cool.
So thank you guys for watching. Don't forget to like, subscribe, hit the notification button, and we'll catch you on the next video. Thank you guys. God loves you. We love you. Until next time, God bless.